Hey guys and girls, Sean Evans, the Evans Meister here, and welcome back to my Niles Van Roekel cosplay series. Gold Coast Supanova is literally next weekend, and I gotta say, I'm really looking forward to it. This will be the final update before, hopefully, the reveal, provided that everything doesn't go to shit at last minute. Everything's all cut out, everything's all painted. It's time to start putting everything on. I've decided to forego the gluing every single thing on, because as soon as I started trying that, it wasn't really working out. So instead, Velcro. Started sticking Velcro straps on all the pieces and onto parts of the suit, and super glued them down so they don't go anywhere. I need to go to the shop later on today to buy more super glue and more Velcro, because I've run out of super glue and I'm almost out of Velcro. But so far I have roughly assembled the suit onto the mannequin in my living room. And a little underwhelming, if I'm to be honest. I wasn't expecting it to look that crash hot anyway, but the parts hang a little loose on the mannequin because, of course, I cut it to my own measurements and the mannequin is far thinner than me, but still, it kind of looks sad. There are parts of it that I'm proud of, there are some that I'm not too proud of, but bottom line, it is taking shape and it should be ready for Comic-Con.
I'm fucking knocking on wood like crazy.
Okay, so this is how the suit looks so far. Just like a rough assembly here. And I must say, I am pretty underwhelmed. I'm probably not gonna try and make a costume again, because look. But again, like I've said before, it's a first effort. So, you know, I expect it to be perfect. I will admit, I do like how the mask turned out. I used cream paint and mixed cream with a bit of Payne's Grey to get the definition in the wrinkles there and in the creases there. Not much I could do about the goatee though. So yeah, as shoddy as the rest of the paintwork is, that's turned out pretty well. I'm quite proud of myself for that one. Shoulder cores are somewhat okay. A lot to be desired, because you know, there's a lot of space and gaps in between there, and some of the paint's come off. I'll just turn on all the... So those lit up from a distance, it looks okay. Also, the thigh armor's gone down a bit because the mannequin's legs are a lot slender than mine. I do still have some parts to put on, like, you know, the ab tubes and the bicep plates, and you know, that goes on my ass. And I also got the back armor slash thrusters there. Again, doesn't look too good. And I should have just cut it in half and then glued that on. But if I try and rip it off now, I'm probably gonna make a hash of it. And this is something else I'm trying out just for the hell of it. It's Roekel's normal clothes. Because when he's not wearing the armor, he wears what the scientists would usually wear. You know, lab coat and civilian clothes. I bought the lab coat for my Rick Sanchez costume, but you know, I already dressed up as him for Supanova already. Okay, so that concludes this little update. And I presume as a whole, it kind of concludes this series, you know, making an Niles Van Roekel cosplay, minus the reveal, of course. The plan was to film like a reveal trailer kind of thing in the same sort of style of like a character teaser for a project, like an MCU project. But cast your mind back to X-Men Origins Wolverine, as much as people want to forget that. I'm fine with it. But like, for the promotion of that film and among the special features on the disc, there were like videos on the characters that started off with, you know, them standing in like a spotlight and them talking about themselves.
All I ever wanted was to travel to far off exotic places, meet new and exciting people, and then kill them. So I became a mercenary. My name is Wade Wilson. And I love what I do.
That is kind of what I wanted to do for the reveal, that kind of style. But of course that all depends on, you know, how the suit is, and I guess the practicality of doing that, because I am by myself. I don't have anyone around willing to help me. Ian's been moved up north since February. So this is, you know, very well a one-man show. It pretty much always has been. I just realized I said earlier that concludes our video, and then I just went off on a tangent. But yeah, that finally wraps up the video. And if it turns out the suit doesn't really function very well, well, I have a bunch of other costumes I can go in. But anyways, I hope you're all doing okay, and I'll see you guys and girls next time. Laters.